Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. It's Eva from Bohemian Crafting and today I'm coming to share with you what I have created from magazine and old envelopes. I hope you will enjoy it. I'm gonna swap my camera view and show you how I have created this one. Today I'm coming with a magazine and newspaper craft. I was reading today at morning this magazine. I love this magazine so much. We do have so many of these series, and I came on this Elizabeth Taylor column, and I already started, and I'm kind of in the middle of the work. I have cut out a few images from this column. Here was Elizabeth with her son, and here was these two images. And like this, and I already started, and I'm cut out something, and I'm using one of my old envelopes, mail envelopes, which came with, you know, daily mail. And I was thinking why I will don't share with you how I am using my magazine and newspapers images. I'm gonna finish this one with you, and then I'm gonna do another one to show you also those first steps I'm going I'm making. I just need few, I think, numbers, and in our, I'm gonna also, because that magazine is in Czech language and I wanna mix it with English language, so I'm gonna have a look to Rodrem advertiser, and I'm gonna cut out definitely some numbers and maybe some words, and I will come back. So I'm gonna show you what I've got here. I've got these images from that Czech magazine. I've got these numbers here and these letters from our Rodrem newspaper. Before I started to do this video, I cut out first from old envelope. I cut out a rectangle, a little bit smaller than is my envelope. And also I have cut out for this flap, also from that old envelope, I cut out this, I tried to cut it kind of similar way, like is this flap of this envelope. And then from that rectangle, I cut out the frame. I think it's 1 inch, 1 inch wide, maybe a little bit more, 1 1/4. And then once I had that frame from the old envelope, I took my graphite paper and I cut a little bit smaller frame from that graphite paper. When you are using graphite paper, this square, it's very easy to cut it. So it wasn't that hard to cut smaller frame. I glue it down. I cut rectangle for this inside piece, glue it down, and then I made these sewn effects. I used tea. This is just some old spray bottle, but inside I do have tea, and I used tea. And also for those kind of grungy spots, I used these Faber-Castell pastels. And they are, it's beautiful collection of colors, and I used this one and this one a little bit, just a little bit, kind of sand it here and then there, and use that spray again, and let it dry outside on the sun, because today it's beautiful weather outside. So I let it dry outside, and it made these shades. And also here you can see that a little bit better, how beautiful shades it made, because it's, I forgot that bright word, it's melting in color, in water, oh my. So I'm gonna put it together, I'm not gonna even try to remember the right word. So what I would like to do, I would like to do some background, some layout from these images in the back, and then fix my frame. And also fix this one, and I forgot to cover it. So I think I'm gonna start with this. I've got somewhere left over from that graphite paper right here. So I'm gonna show you how I made it, because it's really easy. Let's So I just draw the shape. And then with my scissors, I cut a smaller. The shape, but a little bit like inside. And it makes it smaller and I can fit it to my base piece. The base piece. Like this. And I will cut it a little bit more. This is too. No, it's good. It's good. Maybe here I will cut a little bit from here to make that beautiful frame around. It should go. So I'm gonna glue it down. I'm gonna sew all around. So I have glued that graphite paper and I sewn all around. I also glued these two small numbers on this graphite paper. I'm gonna make kind of like frame around. And here I will use, I think, distress ink and distress it a little bit. I'm not sure yet. I need to cut it a little bit smaller. And here. And this one. So I will have my mini labels. I was thinking that I will sew it also, but this is too small. And I glued these, this number and this no job too small. And I think for Lizzie it's totally amazing. She was amazing actress. Really amazing. So I do have this one, and I forgot to tell you, I glued that picture from that magazine also on that old envelope, and then I cut it around. And then for those edges, if you will notice, I can see a little bit of that envelope. So what I did, I just sand the edges with my nail file, just a little bit to give that frame around, and that used like old look. So what I did with the envelope and frame, I'm gonna show you now. I'm gonna move this, and I do have that tea in my spray. So I sprayed first, and I close it back. Why I did it? Then I took the dark gray color, and I still have a lot here, so I guess, and I just kind of grind it down or sand it down like this. I can add there also a little bit of that dark brown, but I don't have to, I guess. Like this, and then I took my spray again and I sprayed a little bit more, and it made those beautiful melted, it made that beautiful melted effect. So I'm gonna place it on the sun and I'm gonna let it dry, and meanwhile while it's drying that cover for this flap, I'm gonna do something here. I know I would like to have there this picture and this small column underneath, because I can see I used the paraffin or wax, and I used my heating tool to make it, you know, transparent a little bit. I do have this technique on my YouTube channel. I will try to find that video and post it down, post the link down there in the description box, and I can see through to that writing. So that's why I made this technique. So I think I'm gonna place it somewhere here, and I was thinking this on this small piece somehow. Not sure yet this one, I will see. So first I would like to do some stamping underneath, and I do have here my stamps. These stamps I made by cutting my larger stamps, like background stamps, which I didn't use. This is, I think, from Dawcraft. And there is so many. And these numbers I made using my dies. I cut out using my dies. I cut out these numbers from fleece. Is it fleece? Felt? Fleece or felt? I think felt is the right word. So I cut it from felt and I made few layers and I'm using it like stamps. So I'm gonna use something from this. And I will do small background stamping. And I'm gonna use, I think, walnut stain. No, there is a lot of black and red, so I need to use that. Black and red. Okay. And here I do have just normal office inks. Nothing like super exciting. Just normal office. And I think I'm gonna stamp it here. Yeah, maybe. And maybe here. Where I will have this one, I think. Somewhere here. Okay. Alright. And here. I do have their smaller stamps as well. And because I do have that red color, quite lots of red color on that envelope and here on these pictures as well. And also I choose those red numbers. I'm gonna stamp also something in red. And it should be numbers. So I'm gonna have a look. Some letter. Letter. Some numbers. Because she is here with her son. And I think her son was born in 1954. I wasn't too far. 1953. Here 1953. Her son, Michael. So I'm gonna use 5 and 3. I was good with the choosing of those numbers. So here on the bottom, I'm gonna place these numbers. And this strip, it's from Oro Rodrem. Newspapers, that advertiser, and I'm gonna take my red ink and somewhere I'm gonna stamp 53. So I have tried to stamp it, but I don't like it. It's like very vanished and I'm not gonna use it, and this is actually to do too fragile, so I'm gonna use this is that leftover where I placed that Liz Taylor with her son, pardon me, which I used for background. I'm gonna use this beautiful die from Marianne Design. Here you can see the name of the company, Marianne Design, and the number of these dies. I love them so much. It's COL1418. If you are looking for some good die for numbers, I do love the shape of these numbers so much. So I'm gonna use, instead of that stamping, I'm gonna use this, and I'm gonna use this old envelope. But I think I would like to have there some, you know, something. So I think I'm gonna use the rest of this, glue it on the page, and then cut the number. So I'm gonna take it off from the magazine, glue it on that envelope, how big it is, And see, they are writing here that she had, Liz Taylor had kind of like anomaly. And because of that, her eyelashes was growing in two rows, in two layers. So she was very lucky woman. It's very visible. See, look at her eyes. She's got beautiful eyelashes. So I'm gonna do that. So I have cut the numbers, and I'm gonna take black suit, distress ink, and I'm gonna just a little bit kind of distress edge, and then with my finger I'm gonna spread it. Just make it a little bit vintage looking, just the edge, and then I'm gonna kind of wipe it down with my finger, just like that, and the dies looks like this. You can see that now they are really beautiful. I like them so much, and sometimes I do forget to use them. But I was reminded that by Tina, her channel, I just saw that I think yesterday or day before. Shabby Dabby Dudah? Oh, maybe I'm saying that wrong way. Oh, I'm not sure. But it's Tina's channel, and she made amazing 12x12 collage sheet. I'm gonna post the link for that video down below, and from those sheets she made tags and pockets and amazing stuff. So I'm gonna put it down below, and she did use these dies, so it kind of came back to my mind. Oh, I do have them. So here we've got numbers, and I'm coming back with this. I do have dry already the flap here, so I guess I'm gonna start with this. I'm gonna glue it down straight away, or no? Come on. Okay, I do. So I'm gonna glue this. Oh, here. So I will have a little bit stronger this flap, which I want. And then that rest. I think I would like to have that frame here. So I'm gonna make a position of those papers. This will be somewhere here. And see? Son name, it's Michael, and here is big M. It's not the Michael name on it, behind it, but there is the M. So it's amazing. Like this, and like this. I think I can do it this way. Yes, so I'm gonna glue those two images. So I do have glued that background image, and I think I'm gonna decorate that frame first before I will do the moving part, because this will have moving part. So I would like to have her and her son somewhere here. I would like to have there also the number, so I guess how much space you need. 1953. It can be a little bit over the edge. She's gonna be here, but because the image had cutted legs, yeah, it can be this way. Oh, it can be this way as well. I think. I think I will like it this way more. Yeah, I will like it this way more. So first I'm gonna fit the 1953 number because it needs quite big space. And number one. Oi! What are you doing? Number one. Like this. Now I'm gonna glue Elizabeth Taylor with her son. So they can be right here. So I'm gonna put glue here, I guess, and definitely on the bottom of their legs. I think somewhere here. And I'm gonna take some stencil because I forgot. Before I will glue anything else, I'm gonna do some stenciling. You could hear this beautiful stencil. I got it from AliExpress, this one. I will have a look if I do have link, but I've got it for a long time, so I'm not sure if I still have a link. But I think I already shared the link for this stencil. I'm not sure about that. But I think I did. While ago. So I'm gonna do just very soft stenciling. I've got on my distressing tool, I've got leftover from black ink, and that's what I'm using. So I do have that family done. I'm gonna glue this on the top, and I think I'm gonna punch their holes and fix the eyelets to make it even more beautiful. I'm gonna place it in the middle and put the eyelets here in those ends. So I'm gonna punch the holes in one end and in that other end as well. Hopefully I'm gonna be kind of on a similar spot ish. And I'm gonna fix it here and here. So I do have kind of that base. I still got here these numbers, but that base I do have done, my frame and that background. And I've got here this strip. I did it by eye, so not gonna tell you measurement, but I will prepare some another video with tutorial with this folding. Should be pop-up card. I hope it will work. I made it by eye. I'm gonna show you when it's folded. This leg, it's nearly similar. It's just a really small bit here over the edge, and then I do have this extension here. I can tell you it's 3/4 of inch. Here is 1 inch score line, and this is 1 inch. 1 inch and 1 inch triangle. But I will make some tutorial better way where I will explain what I did. So I'm gonna glue first this fold here. Somewhere I will have to have a look where I would like to have that frame. Somewhere here I would like to have that frame. So here it will hold that frame. And also this inside of that frame. I'm gonna glue this, then I'm gonna fold this one, put the glue there, and fold this one, and place it down. Yeah, my hands are not clean, too much. Then I'm gonna put the glue here on this small triangle. And I'm gonna take this cardstock and place it here. Just in the triangle, not over those folds. Just in the triangle, and I'm gonna wait to let it dry. So it's all dry, and I'm gonna take that frame and place that frame on this part. So I'm gonna put the glue on all this to make sure, not on that triangle here that can't be touched, but on all this, and let it dry again, and then I will show you how it looks like. So here, and I'm gonna let it dry properly. And I think I am done with my newspapers layout with movable part. So I think this video, it's long enough. Here it has to be a little bit pushed back, but it's working. I think this video, it's long enough. I'm gonna finish now. Where did it get you stuck? Come on. Ah, good. Good boy. So I added those numbers here, here, and one here. And I do have my magazine newspaper layout done, and old envelopes, of course. So this is my sharing for today. I hope you did enjoy it. I will try to do some video with this movable part. It's stucking somewhere. I think it's that stitching. That stitching is behind this window here. I forgot to cover that window, so it will be probably, yeah, it will be that. That stitching is dropping here over that edge, so I will have to try to somehow cover it. I will choose some picture from that magazine probably and try to glue it underneath. So have a good day, take care about yourself, and thank you so much for stopping by. Bye.